Hi everyone, today I'm going to be doing the very long-awaited Ordinary skincare review. I have never reviewed a skincare line before, and I am definitely not an expert on skincare. So if you are looking for something that's going to be like super informative and like professional, that's not the video. I would find something else to watch. But ever since my no makeup makeup video where I mentioned doing this type of video, I have gotten so many requests to review the skincare line, and I feel like I've been using it for long enough, so that's what we're doing today. But I'm just going to be reviewing products and letting you guys know what I am going to be like repurchasing for sure, and what I feel like I am going to be skipping, and how I feel about things and stuff like that. And honestly, like, some of the stuff I don't even know how I feel. I just use it because it's like skincare and I know I should be taking care of my skin. Again, like what I said, if you are wanting something that's going to be super professional and like knowledgeable, this is not the video. I am a makeup person. I am not a skincare person, but I feel like the way that my skin has been with the skincare line, I am going to continue using this stuff, and it's also super duper affordable. I will talk about things in like the steps that I would use them. This is the Squel. Okay, also a lot of these things are going to be pronounced incorrectly, or I'm not even going to attempt to pronounce them. I'm sorry. This is the squalene cleanser. I don't know what squalene means, and I don't even know if I'm saying that correctly, but this is a face cleanser and a makeup remover. I bought one for my boyfriend and he didn't use it because it said makeup remover on it, like an idiot. Like, you can use it if you're not wearing makeup too, Justin. But this cleanser is really lovely. I wish it was larger. This is the size that we sell, and I go through it not quickly, but this is my... Hi, Beans. Hi, Beans. Wilma, don't be a little jerk. Look at her. She's wagging her tail now. Oh my gosh, what a little love fest back there. Wilma, you're just so wiggly for Beans. How cute are my little dogs? That's Bean back there. I don't really talk about her too often, because like Wilma's always with me and Wilma's my dog, but Bean is like my sister, you know, they're like, she's like my parents' dog, but she's still very much a part of the family. I better go get Wilma though, she's going to run away. But I love this cleanser. I wish I could buy it in a larger size. In conjunction with a cleansing balm, right now I'm using my Clinique cleansing balm to take off my makeup, so I will use that. I'll let it soak in, kind of break down my makeup, and then I go in with this cleanser, and I feel like it does a really good job taking everything off, which is really, really nice. I feel like people with dry skin and oily skin would like this cleanser a lot. And also, I know that this line doesn't use any like fragrance or anything, so people with sensitive skin could use it as well. So next is the Glycolic Acid 7% Toning Solution. I don't use this one in the morning, I use this one in the evening. I think because it would make your skin a little bit more sensitive to the sun, so they recommend that you use it in the evening. I like to use this as kind of just like an extra step to get any of the like the dirt and grossness off of my skin. And I do find this to be kind of a dupe for the Glossier solution, like their exfoliant. I think the Glossier solution is a little bit more like hardcore than this stuff is, but I have like a similar effect as this. I don't know if this is intended to be used as like an exfoliant or a chemical exfoliant. I have another product from them that is a chemical exfoliant. Oh, it does have AHA in it, and I know that is a chemical exfoliant, so yeah, I do think that this is like a kind of affordable dupe to the Glossier solution. If you were interested in trying something like that but didn't want to spend the money, you might like something like this, but I do think that it makes my skin feel like extra clean afterwards, and it's like so much product for really affordable, so this is gonna last me a really long time. And then I'll also talk about the peeling solution that I have. It's the AHA 30% plus BHA 2% peeling solution 10-minute exfoliating facial. I like to use this once or twice a week. I like to use it on days of the week where I feel like my skin really needs a good exfoliation. This stuff really, I feel, works. It does tingle a little bit and like sting, but not anything super unbearable. But I think it does do a really good job at like exfoliating my skin and getting rid of any like dead skin that I have. And I wake up in the morning feeling like really fresh faced. Chemical exfoliants are way better for your skin than those like solid exfoliants. So I've read. I don't know. And then after exfoliating, if you are going to be out in the sun, I definitely don't recommend using either of these products during the day. Like, this is definitely like a nighttime routine type product, but they do have an SPF. This is the Mineral UV Filters SPF 30 with antioxidants. I don't use this SPF very often at all. It gives me a really, really bad white cast, so I don't like it. I'll show you in the back of my hand. It like is one of those types of sunscreens. Like, I'll really try and blend it in, but it gives me just like the worst white cast. Like, I think if you were very fair, maybe you could get away with using it, and it's very inexpensive and the ingredients are like really clean, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think that they use pretty clean ingredients. Like, what you buy is what you buy, basically. You're not buying like a bunch of filler and stuff. And I also really like this, I don't know how to say this word, but it's something acid suspension 10% multifunctional brightening formula. I like this product. I don't really even know what it is. I don't think it's a moisturizer because it's not moisturizing. It keeps me like kind of matte throughout the day, which is interesting. I feel like I should be using it a little bit more, like especially in the T-zone. But ever since I started using like this product and another product that I'm about to show you, it has like their brightening stuff in it. It has like a lot of vitamin C in it. I've noticed a huge difference in my skin. My skin reacts really, really well to vitamin C. It keeps my skin really clear and bright. And vitamin C's can get pretty expensive. So the fact that I can get this stuff for like dirt cheap and still take really good care of my skin, I really appreciate that. I'm gonna continue using these like forever, probably until it doesn't work anymore. So yeah, whatever this product is, I don't know really even what it is. So for the actual moisturizer, this is the Ordinary Natural Moisturizing Factors Plus HA, which I assume is hyaluronic acid. They do have a hyaluronic acid, which I probably will look into getting when we get closer to winter, when my skin gets a little bit more dry, but I definitely didn't really need it over the summer. But I love this face moisturizer. Like, it is so nice. It's huge. I wish that the cleanser came in this size and like the moisturizer came in the cleanser size. Like, that would be perfect. But I adore this stuff. I think it keeps my skin really nice and hydrated, but not like overly hydrated where it makes me feel like really oily. It's like a perfect, very basic face moisturizer. I feel like a lot of people with a lot of different skin types would be able to use this guy. I'm not going to attempt to say these two words because I don't want to embarrass myself, but this is the brightening serum with Stabilize vitamin C derivatives. I've used up a ton of the serum. I adore it. I think it definitely played a big part in what got my skin clear. I was dealing with a lot of bad pimples on my cheeks. I think it had a lot to do with like using a bronzer that was like a little bit too old, but I was really struggling with that. And then I switched over to using the Ordinary and I saw a difference in my skin within a week. And I think a lot of it has to do with this vitamin C serum. I love vitamin C. Like I said earlier, it really keeps my skin nice and clear. And this one is perfect. So I highly recommend this if you like using vitamin C on your skin. I know it's like really good for keeping your skin nice and bright and to help lighten up any like acne scarring and stuff. I don't know if it like keeps people's skin clear, but I feel like it keeps my skin clear, so. And then I also use the caffeine solution, which reduces the appearance of eye contour pigmentation and puffiness. I love this stuff. I wish I had a mini skincare fridge so I can keep this in that and then like use it in the morning. It'll be like extra cooling, but I feel like it's already pretty cooling underneath my eyes in the morning. But I feel like it really does a good job at like waking up that under eye area. It also makes my under eyes look very nice and hydrated and makes for a really nice like base for makeup. And then last from the brand that I have the Organic Cold Pressed Moroccan Argan Oil for skin and hair. I really like it for my skin. I don't break out from this. For a little bit, I was mixing these two together. So the vitamin C serum and the Moroccan oil, I was kind of using that as my moisturizer before I got this guy. I did not break out from it at all. It kept me very hydrated, and I especially would use it like before bed to give me like a lot of extra hydration. I did try it in my hair. I feel like my hair is too thin for it though. Like even if I would use a very small amount, it made my hair like extra, extra oily. So I don't recommend it for hair if you have like thin hair like me, but for the skin, it feels very nice and I am happy that I have it. So that is my review of The Ordinary. I do really want to get my hands on that Ordinary like foundation serum. I got a comment about that recently from someone wanting me to review it, and I think I will now. Because why not? Hopefully you guys got something out of this review. I know that the brand is a little bit intimidating, so hopefully this kind of helped you know what products you wanted to pick up. I definitely don't own everything from the brand. They have so many things, but this is what I own and this is what I've been using and what I've been liking. I really like everything from the brand except the SPF. I don't love that, but everything else I have been loving, and I've been so impressed by everything, especially because it's so dirt cheap. The skincare brand Curology reached out to me a few weeks ago, and I was really excited about that because they wanted to do like a sponsored video, and they went ahead and sent me like a trial of it. But honestly, I have not been motivated to like even try it just because I've been loving the stuff from The Ordinary, which kind of sucks because I'm sure Curology was gonna pay me like, you know, a little bit of money to make a video. But I just don't have motivation to like try another skincare line right now just because I know The Ordinary is working so freaking well for me. If this isn't like the review that you're wanting, I'm really sorry. I don't know how to film skincare reviews, and I don't typically watch skincare reviews on YouTube like really ever. I just use what I think I would like and then I form my own opinions on it, and that's that. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you did still get something out of this video. If you have questions that I didn't answer in this video, you can leave them down below and I will answer them. But that is going to be it for me today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Go ahead and subscribe if you want to be notified whenever I post a new video, and hopefully I see you next time.